Hello everybody and welcome to another Datastage tutorial with Learn at Knowstar. In today's video, we are going to take a look at some of the differences between the join, lookup and merge stages. As Datastage developers, we are all aware that all these three stages can be used whenever there is a need to combine data from different data sources through a Datastage job. Then which one to choose over the other? What are the differences between these? Let's try to understand that by taking a look at the following points. To understand the differences between these three stages, the first point that we need to consider are the memory requirements or the memory usage for these three different stages and the sorting requirements for the input data sets for these three different stages. The lookup stage works by storing the reference data set in its memory, and therefore obviously its memory requirements are high. The merge and join stages, on the other hand, do not store the data in the memory, and therefore they need the input data sets to be sorted in order to perform their operation. Therefore, that is the first difference, that the lookup stage do not require the input data to be sorted, whereas the merge and join stages do require the input data sets to be sorted and key partitioned. The lookup stage requires more memory because it creates a dynamic lookup table, whereas the merge and join stages use less memory as compared to the lookup stage. The other difference is in the type of joins that can be performed between the different data sources while combining the data. Using a lookup stage, we can perform a join which can be of the kind of a left outer join, also an inner join if we select the drop option while performing the lookup. The merge can also either keep the records from the master link or drop the records, so you can perform the outer join as well as kind of an inner join. The join obviously stage is one stage where you can explicitly specify the inner join, the left outer join, the right outer join and the full outer join. Now full outer is one of the joins that can only be performed using the join stage. So the lookup and merge stage will not allow you to perform a full outer join. Therefore, if that is a requirement, you need to go for the join stage. The right outer join can be performed using a workaround using the lookup and merge stages by kind of flipping or interchanging the primary and secondary links. The third difference that we need to analyze is in the way the rejects are captured by these three different stages. The lookup will allow you to have a reject data set which would capture the rejects from the primary link in case you select the option in the lookup as reject. The merge stage, on the other hand, allows you to capture the rejects from the secondary links, which are known as the update links. In join, there is no provision to capture a reject using a reject link, but you can capture it by incorporating some logic using a transformer and capturing the nulls to identify any mismatches on either the left side or the right side of the link. Another way in which the three stages would differ is in the way they work when they're duplicates in either the primary link or the secondary link. So for a lookup stage, if there are duplicates in the primary link, the lookup stage works fine. But if there are duplicates in the reference link, then a warning would be thrown. You can also obviously change the setting and allow multiple matches from the reference link to be returned to the output link from the lookup stage. In case of a join, if there are duplicates in either the primary link or the secondary link, then it might only result in Cartesian product if there are duplicates on both the sides, but it would not be throwing any warning in the Datastage director log. But in case of merge, if there are any duplicates in the primary link, which is also known as the master link in the merge stage, then it results in inaccurate results in the output of the merge stage. So therefore, it is an absolute requirement that in case you are wanting to use the merge stage, you have to remove duplicates from your primary link. There's also a warning thrown in the director log. If the duplicates in the secondary link, then it is okay in case it is only one update link that is connecting to the merge stage, because merge stage has the ability to have more than one secondary links connected to it. Now that we understand the differences between the three stages, another important question is that which stage is the most efficient? Now this is an example that has been taken from the IBM documentation. Three different jobs were designed, one using the lookup stage, one using the merge stage, and one using the join stage. These three jobs are performing the same operation, working on the same set of data, and having the same transformations. All the environmental characteristics are also the same. The memory, the hard disk, the CPU requirements, and the node configurations are the same. Now, if we take a look at the resource utilization statistics, we can see that the job that used the joint stage runs the fastest and gives the most optimized performance. There's a usage of scratch disk for job 2 and 3, which use the merge and the joint stages because they require the input data sets to be sorted and keep partitioned. There is a huge memory requirement and utilization for the lookup stage, and it also takes the maximum amount of time to process the data. So looking at these statistics, we can infer that joint stage is mostly the optimized stage to be used in most of the scenarios. But this definitely does not mean that we have to use a joint stage in all scenarios. There might be certain scenarios in which we might need to use one of the specific stages. So let's try to understand some of those scenarios. The general guidelines are that whenever the reference data set is small and can fit into memory, then the lookup is the best stage that should be used because it would give you the fastest performance. The merge stage is very rarely used, and one specific criteria where you might need to use a merge stage is when you have a specific requirement to capture regics from your secondary links. Joint stage in most scenarios gives the most optimal performance, and one specific use case for joint stage is when we need to perform the full outer join, because that cannot be performed by either the lookup or the merge stage. So on a higher level, use a lookup stage when your reference data set is small, otherwise go for a joint stage. Merge stages use only when you have a specific requirement to capture regics from your secondary link. So these are the key differences between the lookup, merge, and join stages. I hope that you found this video useful. If you did, then please do comment, share, and like this video. And please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you and stay safe.